and welcome to my last assembly as your head of year. Since there's a long holiday ahead, can I recommend to you Doctor Who as a box set? All of the new Who, i.e. the Doctor Who series recorded in this millennia, are available free on iPlayer. I've always loved Doctor Who since I started watching it in the 1970s. And what got me thinking about it this week was the handover between heads of year. And it stops me talking to you in these assemblies about wildlife photography and going on about Charlton Athletic all the time. Let me explain. Those of you who know the show will know that the Doctor is a Time Lord, and Time Lords don't die, they regenerate. They get a new face. It was originally conceived as a way of keeping the show going in the 1960s, when the first Doctor Who actor William Hartnell became ill in 1966. It was used as an explanation of the change of appearance of the actor to that of Patrick Troughton. But the concept of regeneration isn't just a change of face. Each new Doctor has a completely different personality, idiosyncrasies, and their own way of doing things. However, all of them have the same values. In recent Doctor Who episodes, the Doctor's promise to himself has been referred to on a number of occasions. Never cowardly or cruel, never give up, never give in. In quite recent regeneration scene, as Peter Capaldi left the series, there was quite a moving rendition of this promise. As he talks to his future self, he says, "You wait a minute, Doctor. Let's get it right. I've got a few things to say to you. Basic stuff first. Never be cruel, never be cowardly. Remember, hate is always foolish and love is always wise. Always try to be nice and never fail to be kind. Laugh hard, run fast, be kind." And then he says, "Doctor, I let you go." And he regenerates into the next rendition of the Doctor. On another occasion, the same actor, Peter Capaldi, phrased it like this: "Never be cruel, never be cowardly, and if you ever are, always make amends." Seems to me to be a decent policy and a decent philosophy for living your life. But what's this got to do with heads of year? In your time at Wilson, you'll have up to seven heads of year, and they'll all look different, and they'll all have their own personality and their own approach. But I believe they'll also have similar core beliefs, and they'll have very similar motivations for doing the job. Essentially, we are all about looking after you, our year group. Sometimes we have to be firm, sometimes compassionate, but our role is to promote pastoral support and look after you. Another parallel is the role of the Doctor's companions. The Doctor, like a head of year, can't do what he's doing on his own. And I'd very much like to thank Mr. Cady, Mrs. Schofield, Mr. McLaughlin, Miss Banner for all of the support that they've given to me and to you this year. But most of all, I'd like to thank your form tutors, your daily point of contact, who've all been excellent. Miss Hughes, Mr. Ironside, Madame Mulcahy, Mr. Carew Robinson, Dr. Meddleton, Mrs. Kitson, Dr. Claydon, Dr. Johnson, Mr. Stobie, and Mr. Fletcher have all shown themselves to be great allies of mine and yours. And as often happens when the Doctor regenerates, they will be with you and your new head of year. But most of all, I'd like to express my thanks to Miss Hardy and Miss Ip, who are in very different ways amongst the best and most committed form tutors that I've worked with, both of whom are leaving Wilson's this week to further their careers elsewhere. I'll personally miss them both, and I'm sure you will too. But back to regeneration. Who will your new head of year be? You won't have to wait too long to find out.
But before I go, can I thank you for being a fantastic year group in the strangest of years? And remember, never cowardly or cruel, never give up, never give in.
Hi, year 9, or should it be year 10? I'm your new head of year, and I honestly can't wait. Have a great summer, and I'll see you in September.